So let us try to go back and solve our exponential equations. So this is where the logarithms will come handy. In particular, we have seen one property of logarithm. For example, if I am talking about a raised to x, and if I talk about log to the base a of a raised to x, I get x. This property we have to emphasize and track everything in terms of this property and solve the exponential equations while solving the using logarithms. So let us try to get hands on these exponential equations using the logarithm. So first you have to solve this equation. Naturally we have to solve for x. So the equation is 2 raised to x plus 1 is equal to 64. Now as you know earlier that this is not more of logarithm but more of inspection. So 64 seems to be a nice number, so you can write 64 as 16 into 4 is 64, but 16 is nothing but 2 raised to 4 into 2 square. So what you got here is 2 raised to 6. So my 64 can be written as 2 raised to 6. Now I have been asked to solve for this equation, that is 2 raised to x plus 1 is equal to 64. So essentially 2 raised to x plus 1 equal to 2 raised to 6 if and only if. So you can take this 1 2 out. 2 raised to x is equal to 2 raised to 5. Hit the function with a logarithm and use the property. Okay, so use the property log to the base a of a raised to x is x. Hit the function with logarithm, and you know logarithm is 1 to 1 function, so nothing changes. What should be my a? It should be 2. Then naturally I will get log to the base 2 of 2 raised to x is equal to log to the base 2 of 2 raised to 5. Using this property you can actually write this as x is equal to 5. This is my answer. I have solved this expression. So my answer to this question is x is equal to 5. Let us look at the second example. This is also an exercise in computation where I will try to match these two, but it becomes slightly complicated because as you can see it involves the term containing x square. So again the question is to solve for x. So let us solve for x. So let me first simplify the right hand side. E raised to minus x square is equal to e raised to, this e raised to x the whole square using law of indices will become 2x, and this 1 by e raised to 3 will become minus 3. Again you use the natural log, take ln on both sides. If you take ln on both sides using the same property that I mentioned earlier, I will get x square is equal to 2x minus 3. That simply means I have a quadratic equation which says x square plus 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. Use our knowledge of quadratic functions or quadratic equations, and in this case the quadratic equation I think can be solved with by a very easy solution, that is x plus 3 into x minus 1. This is simply by factoring. You just look at the lectures on quadratic functions and see how to solve the equation by factoring. Actually I will split this into x square plus 3x minus x minus 3. That will give me minus 1 as common, and the first factor is x plus 3. So this is how I will solve. Done. So now what I have as an answer is x is equal to 3 minus 3 and x is equal to 1. Now remember, we are solving some equations where the domains and codomains may not be defined properly, then we may land up in infeasible solution. So always check whether these two functions will work here or not. Let us substitute this x is equal to minus 3 over here, and you can verify that it perfectly works, and x is equal to 1 also perfectly works. Therefore, these both are actually the solutions to the problem. Let us complicate the matters a bit more by putting in this kind of equation. Okay, so let me write this equation, and now obviously the question is to solve for x. 9 raised to x minus 2 times 3 raised to x plus 1 minus 27 is equal to 0. So here, if you look at the equations closely before actually handling them, you can see that there is some common feature between this exponent and this exponent. What is that? I have something like 3 square, which is equal to 9 raised to x, correct? And 3 raised to x plus 1, I can take that plus 1 out, so that this 2 will become 6. So 6 times 3 raised to x. Now this thing you can rewrite as 3 raised to x the whole square. Using this trick, it is very easy now to see that this particular thing is 3 raised to x the whole square minus 6 into 3 raised to x minus 27 is equal to 0. Now there are two ways. This equation is actually very similar to a quadratic equation, or you can reword it as it's a quadratic inform equation. Now using this equation, you can actually solve for 3 raised to x, not for x. So let us go ahead and put 3 raised to x as t, and it is t square minus 6t minus 27, which is equal to 0. Again, resort to a method which is like factoring. So 27 can be factored into 9 into 3. 9 threes are 27 with minus sign. So it will be t square minus 9t plus 3t minus 27, which is going to be equal to 0. This will give me, this is if and only if, t minus 9 into t plus 3 equal to 0, correct? Now the question comes, t plus 9 is equal to 0. So I have solved it for t. What is t? T is 3 raised to x. So I have to resubstitute that, and if I resubstitute that, then I get 3 raised to x minus 9 into 3 raised to x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now you have to be little bit careful. So this simply means, using the factor logic, 3 raised to x is either equal to 9 or 3 raised to x is equal to minus 3. Now this should give you an alarm in your head that this particular thing is not possible for any real x. So this option is infeasible. So I cannot solve for this. What about this? Do I know something about this? Again, simple thing is, you hit with a log, you will get the answer. Or in this case, it's more obvious that x is equal to 2 should be the answer. So now, once you got this, you substitute this x is equal to 2 in the original equation and verify that it satisfies the equation. That will be a good cross check. For example, 9 square is 81, 3 square is 3 raised to 3, that is 27. This is 27, 27 into 2 is 54, 54 plus 27, which should give you 81. Yes, so it's a verification, and we have solved this problem successfully. But remember here the occurrence of infeasible solution. Okay, let us take it a step further and see whether I can do something about an equation of this form, which is 5 raised to x minus 2, 3 raised to x plus 2. Unlike previous problems, the bases are not the same. So what should we do about it is the question. So in this case also, we can actually rely on logarithm, and we can blindly hit with a logarithm. But in this case, let us hit both sides of the equation with natural logarithm, or you can take common logarithm, it doesn't matter. 5 raised to x minus 2, which is equal to ln of 3 raised to 3x plus 2. Now, if you have noticed that when you hit with the log of the same base, the other thing gets vanished. But if you hit with a log of some other base, that number will remain unperturbed. But this x minus 2 and 3x plus 2 will come in front. That is x minus 2 ln of 5 is equal to 3x plus 2 ln of 3. Now, this ln of 5 and ln of 3 are nothing but merely some numbers which are getting multiplied with x and 2. So, they are just constants. So, now my equation is actually a linear equation. Let us try to simplify this. So, here there is 3x, here there is x. So, what we will do is, we will take both the parties on one side, that is the parties corresponding to x on one side and parties corresponding to constant on one side. So minus 2 times ln of 5 will remain as it is, plus 2 when it comes here becomes minus 2 and ln of 3. So plus ln of 3, okay, which will be equal to 3x was already there, multiplied with ln of 3, and from here comes x, which is minus x times ln of 5. Okay, so now what I got here is 3x minus x times ln of 5. I want x to come out common. So, I can process it further, which will give me x as a common factor, 3 times ln of 3 minus ln of 5, and here it is minus 2 times, okay. Now, ln of 5 plus ln of 3, you will learn ahead, it will be ln of 15, and if you look at this particular expression, this expression in the square bracket will not be equal to 0. So I can take this expression here. Another thing that you may notice is 3 here can be raised to the power of 3 over there, and you can further simplify. So you will get, in particular, x is equal to minus 2 times ln of 15 upon 3 times ln of 3, that is ln of 27 minus ln of 5, which can further be simplified to, if you want, you will have more precise structure later, 15 square, which will be 225, 1 by 2, and because of this minus sign, it will be ln of 1 upon 225 upon ln of 27 by 5. So, this is again a number, and this resolves the problem for x. Whether these numbers are feasible, yes, they are very much feasible, and therefore, there is no feasibility violation over here. This we will learn in a bit later how to do all these calculations, but as of now this is the answer. Now let us look at this particular example where you cannot solve on your own, but a graphical solution may yield a better answer. So for that, let us look at x plus e raised to x equal to 2. Now if I try to hit this with a log, but before hitting this with log, because I am encountering a plus sign, let me put rewrite this equation as e raised to x equal to 2 minus x. Now hit this expression with a log, so you will get x is equal to ln of 2 minus x, and you are stuck, you cannot go anywhere. Now if I want to solve this equation, again the only thing that right now we are aware of is I will hit it with exponent and I will again get back the same equation, so it is of no use. So let us focus on this equation and let us try to graph this equation. So in particular, I have a function which is ln of 2 minus x which is equal to 0. So now let us try to use some graphical tool like Desmos to graph these equations. So let us go ahead and use Desmos for graphing the equation. And naturally the choice of log is only up to me. So I will use ln or I will use whatever. So ln of 2 minus x, you can see the graph, minus x. Now the point where it cuts 0 is the solution to the problem, and you can actually check using Desmos that the point is actually 0.443. So let us go back and tell everybody that x is equal to 0.443 is the approximate solution to this problem. But in such problem, this is the best that you can do. So today we have seen how to solve exponential problems using graph or using algebraic methods. Thank you.